What's good, rappers and producers? This is your man Jimmy Conway from BeatsForLyricist.com. And in this video, I'm going to put you onto the best website platform for rappers and producers, okay? And that platform is called Bandzoogle. And this is what I use to make my website with, as you can see here. It has a nice background display that changes, give it a fresh look, okay? Go to my home page. Alright, so this is my home page. I have my banner here that shows my logo. Then you scroll down. This part is for producers. I have my beat player here. I have a video showing how to buy beats. And so you can start selling your beats on a platform like this, called Bandzoogle. It's mainly for like rap artists and musicians, but they incorporated some features that I'm gonna show you in a second that made it really nice for producers, all right? So, but this platform is mainly for rappers, okay? And for the rappers or singers, artists, I'll show you this page here. This is the music page, okay? So you could have a music page like this where you display your music. People could come here, they could play your stuff. They could click the share button here, they could share it on Facebook, they could share it on Twitter, they could share it through email, and they give you a shareable link, okay? What else? You could add info to the track if you want. I just added my website and that's pretty much it. Go back real quick. Okay. Although I'm not an artist, what I did was any artist that rocks on my beats, I tell them to send me back the MP3 and I add it to my website and I start promoting their song on Facebook and Twitter. That way they get double the promotion. They're gonna promote the song to their audience, I'm gonna promote the song to my audience, and that just gives them a little bit more reach, okay? What else we got on here? You can create a blog here that, you know, informs your audience about what's going on in your life. Here, I just like to put tips on here for, you know, rap artists to go through, like music marketing tips, how to promote your music. Let's go to how to promote your hip hop music. So yeah, you can create a blog, like a text blog like this. You can make a video blog. I have a page with ebooks here. Here's a social media page where this one will show your Twitter feed. If you're mostly on Twitter, you know, you have a Twitter here, you have a Facebook page. Okay. So people could kind of see what you're about here. My Instagram page. I'm doing a rebranding, so I'm still kind of rebranding everything. So yeah. Here's a YouTube page. And all of these pages are incorporated through Bandzoogle. Okay. As you can see, I have my music marketing tips here. This is my playlist of music marketing tips. Here's my beat making videos. People want to check out my East Coast beats, my soulful beats, whatever. Okay, you can have whatever you want on your YouTube. You know, I'm just showing you what I use it for. Yeah, I have a contact us page. I have an about us page. It's a picture of me. Tells a little bit about myself here. But yeah, I'll create a couple of quick pages just to show you how it works. So I'm gonna come here to my Bandzoogle back office. Okay, so you have different pages you can add. Oh, excuse me, my fault. Jeez. Okay, so let's go to pages. I want to go up here to add a page. Now, these are the different page types you can add as mostly for like rap artists, okay? I mean, artists and producers both. You have a blank page, you have a home page, which is the main page people come to. This is the music page, the page I showed you, like, you know, for rap artists. You have an electronic press kit page or EPK, you know, page you can put up. That's mainly for rappers and artists. You have a shows page. This shows, you know, your potential audience. A list of where your shows are gonna be. Here's the about page I showed you. You can add, you can also add a store page where you can sell your merchandise. There's a photos page where you can have a photo gallery of pictures of you in the studio. Whatever you do, your lifestyle, whatever. Here's a blog page you can add. Contact us page. External links you can add. You can add like say you wanna have a page that links out to Facebook directly or to like a Facebook group. You can do that here. You can have an intro page here. All right. So let me just show you a couple of things real quick. Let me go down further. No, that's it. So let's go to. We'll start off with a blank page. We'll call it goodness gracious. I should have thought about this before I started. We'll call this bookstore. I don't know. No, sorry. No. Let's call it music store, whatever. I'm hit not published. They give you different options here. If you leave it on main page, this will be on the main page of your website. People will actually see this on the top row of your tabs. Sub page, you could put it under. You could put this page under one of the sub. You can make it a sub tab on one of the main tabs, like you saw under my beats tab before. Okay. You can have this page not in the menu at all. And yeah, so I'm gonna leave this as a main page just to show you what it looks like. We're gonna not publish it for now because we're gonna do some work on it. And so navigation menu, we're gonna leave that on. Advanced settings, just I leave it on everybody. You could kind of mess around with this if you want to. SEO options are important. This tells Google what your page is about. If you leave it here, it automatically generate from the page content, basically meaning whatever the first words you type in, the 160 words you type or the first paragraph, they're gonna kind of base it off that. Okay, that's what's gonna show up in Google when people look up your content. Or you can make a custom one and have search engines, you know, search engines will pick up your description from what you put in here, okay? All right, so from here, we're just gonna do automatically generated, whatever. Create page. All right. So now we got a fresh new page here. So right now it's asking us to add a feature. So I'm gonna click here. Now these are the different things I can add. I can add a title, which just is like a big bold text. Then I can add text here. Image and text, quotes, videos, your photo gallery. All the stuff I showed you before. HTML, which is important for producers and artists. I'll show you how to use that in a second for like YouTube videos or your SoundCloud or whatever you like. This is the site-wide player. Right now it says mine is already in use, and I'll show you what I'll show you that in a second. Scroll down a little bit more. You can have a guest book on your page, which basically lets people add comments. here you have a store where you can upload different files for sale, like music files or any kind of digital files you want to add. You can add them here. This is where you're going to add your music. If you want to add a donations page with your PayPal account, you can do that here too. I have one on my front page. Let's see. There's a mailing list sign up form for rappers and producers. This one's better for rappers. Producers, I recommend another one. I recommend aweber.com. It's a lot better for what producers need. But for artists, this is probably definitely good enough for what you need to get people back on your website. Okay. Then you have a poll here. You can ask questions on the polls, see what people like, see what people dislike. And these are where you can connect outside different websites to your website. Like the social media page I had before, where you saw the Twitter and the Instagram and the Facebook I added separately. But yeah, I got that all from here. But for producers, you can add your own Airbit store. They have Airbit already included. All you need to have is your Airbit account, which is crazy. And the great thing about having the Airbit player with the themes that come with Bandzoogle is that everything will match perfectly. Okay, and I showed you on the front website before, but I'll show you again in a second. This is kind of what sold me. As a matter of fact, I'm not gonna do it now. I'll show you the page in a little while. Actually, look at that. Look at this. Move. All right, so we're gonna add a feature. Let me see. Show you that. And down here, some other stuff you can check out on your own time. Flash. You can add a Flash player. Most people don't use Flash anymore, but you can if you want to. You can show your hit counter that shows how many people come to your website. But yeah, so what we're gonna do right now is, like, if you're an artist, let's say you want to add a YouTube video or something like that, we'll add a YouTube video. Okay, so we're gonna click title. I'm gonna call it being that I make beats, I'm just, you know, East Coast hip hop beat. This is for the producers out here, I guess. But this will show producers and artists how you could add your own YouTube video to your website. Okay. So what I want to do is I want to find my video first. Give me 1 second. Well, actually, let me find a playlist. That's even better. So say I want to add one of my East Coast playlists. I go to my East Coast Beats. You want to find the share button. You want to go to where it says embed. Okay. You want to copy this code. Go back to your website. And then I'm going to add another feature, okay? The feature I'm going to add is called HTML code. Now, it'll come to this little screen here. You can tell, you can add your HTML code in any one of these arrow points, okay? I'm going to add it here, at this one right below East Coast Hip Hop Beats. I'm going to paste my code in here. I'm gonna hit preview and boom, I'm gonna hit save. All right, so now I can view my site. Just click view site in the top right hand corner. I like to close frame. And then voila, you can kind of see it, you know. Second. Okay, so that's how you add your That's how you can add a song or your or YouTube video, your SoundCloud songs to your website, okay? What else? What other features can I add on here real quick? Well, actually I should have did this one. Embed just a regular video. Then it says embed code, a video link. Oh, never mind. And it says unable to find video, never mind. Anyway, let's go to add page again. We're gonna add another page. This time we're gonna add a, we're gonna add a store page. Something where you can sell your merch, okay? We're gonna call a store demo. I'm gonna add, leave this on the main page. Not published. You only wanna publish it when you're ready to put it out for good, for people to see. That's why I'm leaving it non-published, okay? From here, I'm just gonna create page. I'm gonna let it do its thing. And it already brings everything up for you. You have digital albums, you can add your tracks here. Physical albums, you can add a store here. Merchandise, you can add another store here. Digital goods, you can add another store here. Okay? So let me see. Let me add a track. Let me see. Track list, play and sell, mix and track song. Let me just see something. I'm going to try this out real quick. Add tracks. Use existing tracks. I'm just going to use existing tracks. If I want to add new tracks, I'll show you the process. You can just add the name here. Add the artist name here. You can upload your file here. This will upload it from your hard drive. Or you can hit, you know, click here if you have a Dropbox. You can add just a preview of the clip if you want. Tell how many, if your song is 3 minutes and you just want to play a minute and 10, you could do that. You can add a custom preview clip if you want to. You can add if you want to have it for download or for sale. If you want it for sale, you can leave it for free. You can require an email address, remember login. You can have a fixed price, or you can have the fans set their price, okay? So let's say, I'm gonna just leave 99 cents on sale. Track notes, you can put anything in here. You can have it automatically generate ID3 tags. And you can have it preview clip only or play the full track, all right? I'm gonna just do preview clip only. I'm gonna hit 20. Well, I'm not gonna do it now, but yeah, this is it, what you would do. I'm just gonna add existing tracks from my playlist I have already. Add that one. Once you add your songs, they'll show here. Hold on 1 second. When you back out, not gonna play right now. Actually, let me just go to view site. I go to view site and I hit close frame. Here's the song, okay? And I can just cycle through the songs here, okay? You can sell these as your album. Like I said, you can do physical albums, you can do merch, or you can do digital goods, okay? That's pretty much it. They do have different subscription plans. So, the first link in the description, I'll leave a link to where you can go and check out Banzoogle for yourself. And you can sign up through there if you're a rap artist or a producer. If you're a producer and you don't have Airbit already, the second link will be the Airbit link. Click the link below and get Airbit first, then come back and get the Banzoogle, okay? But yeah, this is the platform, and this is the platform to go with. And you can actually change your theme. Like, I'm gonna try to change my theme, please bear with me real quick. So like, oh, let me show producers real quick. Right now, as you can see, I kinda have like this blue thing going. Like the blue matches the blue here. Matching the blue links, and it automatically matches my player up to the website. Okay, so that's like crazy. So I kind of make everything kind of blue. That's my color. Down here, like you see it before, like I told you, I have my donate button, and here is my guestbook page. So if an artist wants to, you know, drop a message about the beats, they could do that too. Okay. Anything else? I think that's it. Oh no, it ain't any. Oh my goodness. What? I'm crazy. The crazy thing about Banzoogle, right? For producers, especially, and artists both, you can see where your people are coming from that are listening to your stuff. This is amazing. Like, I can see I got the East Coast USA thing here going. I got some people out west, but mostly out east. I have nothing going on in the Midwest. I got a little bit going down here in Southern Africa here, and some in South America, out here in Europe, Australia. I'm getting some views, and it tells you down here the city where the view is coming from. So let's view all. Actually, let's do this. Because this is what you definitely need to know. You can see how many total visits you get to your website. You can see how many total unique visits you get. This is the average amount of visitors you get per day and the time they spend on your website. Now this is only for the time between February 9th and February 15th. But I could change that to, let's say, let me see if I could do January 1st to now. Apply. All right, so yeah, the numbers dip in and out depending on what's happening that day, you know, marketing wise. But as you can see, I get my biggest support here in the East Coast, New York, Elmsford, Scarsdale area. Country, okay. United States, Ukraine, Canada. Okay, so it shows you the cities, states, and everywhere where they come from. Then it shows you the top pages where they go to. Like, it shows people go to my top pages, my download hip hop beats page, the first page on my website. Producers come here a lot. People come out here to check out my music page, my blog, how to promote hip hop music. How to get a record deal. It also shows you your top sources, okay? Like Twitter, Facebook. It shows you where people are coming from so you could, you know, channel your marketing efforts, you know, better, all right? Getting something out of Switzerland, Hungary. I never heard of Burma, but shout out to Yangon region, excuse me. Shout out to y'all. So yeah, this is very vital information to your business to know where your people are coming from so you could market better to that audience. But for this to work, you need to have Google Analytics set up. So if you don't have Google Analytics set up, that's real easy to set up. Go set up your Google Analytics page, and they have videos that'll show you how to connect it to that page, all right? So yeah, that's definitely that was definitely worth showing you. So yeah, artist, producer, the first link of both for you, okay? That's the link to bandzoogle.com if you want to check out the website here. Let me try to see if I can do something funky real quick. Let me try to change the theme. Let me try to edit theme. Just so you can see that everything kind of stays the same. Man, if this messes up, my bad. But just kind of want to show you everything before you, you know, check everything out. Okay. I'm going to switch it back to this theme anyway, so. Hold on 1 second. Let it do its thing. Okay. So. Come up here, hit view themes. And they have the themes separated by category, okay? So let's say if I want to check out the urban hip hop themes, you could view the theme first before you apply it. View theme. And you can have like a color scheme of your choosing for that theme style. Let me see if I don't like that one. I can go back here. Let's see. View theme. Somber. Let's hit apply theme. Okay, so it shows a little bit of change. Okay. You can choose that theme or you can go to a different theme. But I'm not gonna go to them right now. You can come here and select whatever theme you want. You know, you can check out all the themes you want, and here you kind of, if you're good at website design, here you can kind of like choose your color schemes and make everything kind of look pretty, okay? Once again, the Bandzoogle videos will show you how to use this section. And they also have a demo video for each theme. So they kind of give you like, preview what the theme is going to be about even before you try it. Okay. All right. So once again, this is my Bandzoogle review, best website for rappers and producers. And yeah, the first link in the description below will be the link for the Bandzoogle. If you want to check them out, that's for both rappers and producers. Second link will be the link for Airbit for the producers who do not have an Airbit account. That'll be the second link. And also the third link will be the link for Aweber for the email, for email signups. That's a lot better than, that's the one thing that I would recommend producers upgrade instead of using the Bandzoogle's email, okay? And as you can see, I have my Aweber account here. Yeah. Alright, so Bandzoogle will be the first link for rappers and producers. The second link will be the Airbit link for producers. And the third link will be the link for Aweber for producers. Alright, this is your man Jimmy Conway from BeatsForLyricists.com. I hope you enjoyed this review. And peace out. One love.